I'm Dr. Samina Mitha, and today I want to talk about insulin resistance and some of the common clinical signs that we see on physical exam with some of my patients. So we talked about insulin resistance in another video. It's called Insulin Resistance and Weight Loss, but I'm just going to give you a brief overview of what insulin resistance is. Essentially, when you eat something like a carbohydrate, it gets broken down into small molecules of glucose. This is like sugar, essentially. And so what happens is the pancreas will secrete insulin, and insulin's job is to bind to the receptor sites on the cell, and this will open up these channels that will bring glucose into the cell to be used as energy. And so sometimes when we have too much insulin hanging around in the bloodstream, because potentially the pancreas created too much or is still creating more, even after glucose has been used up or like come out of the digestive tract into the bloodstream. So insulin levels can stay elevated, or even too much glucose by eating it can actually increase the amount of insulin in your bloodstream as well. So when that happens, sometimes the cell can get too bombarded by insulin, and so now it doesn't really know how to respond, and so it'll become resistant to insulin. So now glucose can't get into the cell, and now we have high insulin and high glucose in the bloodstream. So this is what insulin resistance is, and so oftentimes we see this in PCOS patients, and so what we're trying to do is really focus on balancing insulin and glucose. And one of the ways that we do that is with supplementation and diet and lifestyle. But today what I really want to talk about are some of the clinical signs of insulin resistance that you can see on your own body, and some of the things that we can look out for in terms of blood work, and then also family history, and just in general what you should look out for. So the first thing I want to talk about is acanthosis nigrans, and this is a symptom of insulin resistance that we see on the skin. And so we often see darkening of the skin and the skin folds, and this is commonly on the neck area, but then also we see this in the armpits as well. So it's kind of like this photo here. A severe version of it is kind of seen here, where it's really dark. But oftentimes, from what we see actually in clinic, is just just a little bit of discoloration in the fold. So it's not that doesn't have to be that prominent to really be one of the signs of insulin resistance. Okay, so the second one is skin tags, and oftentimes we see different spots on our body. Skin tags are more like a protrusion, so it's like an elevation of your skin. It's commonly the same color as your skin, but oftentimes we see it on the neck area, but it can be on your body as well. So skin tags can be a sign of insulin resistance, and it's a thing to look out for sure. The other thing is androgenic alopecia. So alopecia meaning hair loss, and androgens meaning testosterone. So basically it means, hair loss associated to high androgens in women. So some of the signs, there's different types of signs of this kind of hair loss. One of the first signs to look out for is, your hairline is intact. So like, you still have hair here, but just right up after it, we see a loss of hair in this section. The other type of hair loss in this category is thinning of the hair throughout your whole scalp. So if you feel like your ponytail isn't as thick as it used to be, or like it just feels like your hair isn't as thick, that can also be a sign of androgenic alopecia. And then as you can see here in this photo, like the part starts to open up and become wider, and that is one of the signs that we can see in women that can be affected by hair loss that's related to androgens. And the other thing is the temple area, not as common, but something to look out for as well. Okay. So this one is called hidradenitis suppurativa, and basically it almost looks like boils or abscesses. Sometimes pus will come out of them, And it's kind of in areas where you have sweat glands and where follicles are. So hair follicles, for example. And they're really deep. You can't pop them. Sometimes you even have to go to a dermatologist or the doctor to get them cut open to be drained. So they're pretty severe, but there can definitely be a sign of insulin resistance in patients for sure. And the last one is androgen acne, I would say. And so this is acne really concentrated in this area, in the jawline. And oftentimes it can be deep acne, not the lesions where you can pop, but definitely, those deeper type of lesions that hurt. And they commonly happen around this area. And so if that's the case, if you see any of these symptoms on your body, it's really important to get tested for insulin resistance. And there's two or a couple of tests actually. One is HbA1c. This is how well you're able to process glucose over 3 months. And so oftentimes if this number is greater than 5.2, I'm thinking that the patient could have insulin resistance. So we often do a fasting insulin as well to see what their number could be. So this is a fasted state after 12 hours of fasting, and typically for a healthy cell, you want this to be around 50. If it's greater than that, then it can mean that you have insulin resistance. But oftentimes at that point, an insulin glucose challenge test should be done. This is where you get 75 grams of glucose, you drink it within 5 minutes, and then they test your blood over a series of, couple of blood extractions over 2 hours, and they see what happens with your insulin and glucose after giving a bigger amount of glucose in the body. How does your pancreas respond? How much insulin is created, and how much glucose, or what happens with your glucose over a 2 hour period? So that's also a test to think about as well. So those are like the common lab tests. And the other thing I just really want to talk about is, if you have a family history of diabetes, it's really important to really get tested. And if you have any symptoms that I'm kind of describing or signs, it's really important as well to get tested. But also, if you have, cravings for sugar, that's like, a big one, or carbohydrates. And I always say, like, I always ask patients if they get hangry, if you get irritable, if you haven't eaten in a while, or just you need to take a snack with you anywhere you go because you'll get hungry. These are signs of low blood sugar. So it's a really important sign to like look out for and think about when we're thinking about insulin resistance. So I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, drop them into the comment box below. And just to let you know, like, this is a medical, just advice type of video, or informational video, I should say. And if you really want medical advice, please talk to your medical doctor or your naturopathic doctor before starting anything. But use this video as a guide to figure out if you do need to get tested or not. Thank you, everyone. Take care.